I'm telling you right now, if you fuck around in the gym, if you fuck around doing a few bicep curls, if you isolate, you need to get the base first. So you need to fucking train as hard as you can and push yourself. You need to put yourself on a level where your body doesn't want to keep going. And when you reach that point, you keep going. In regards to my diet, well, I do have two different types of diets. There's basically a bulking diet and a cutting diet. Personally, I have an extremely fast metabolism, which means I can eat a lot of food and not convert that to fat. And that's just based on my ectomorph body type. Cutting diet's a lot different. Personally, I do a keto. Ketogenic diet basically means you can completely cut out all carbs. Now, if you're cutting out all carbs, basically what that means is that your body, in about 3 or 4 days' time, will reach a state known as ketosis. And what that does is it uses the body's fat as energy rather than stored carbohydrates. And that is definitely my favorite type of diet for losing fat. It's really, really hard to keep it up in the beginning, especially considering the fact that if you're used to eating heaps of carbs and you stop, your body craves it. So it's really, really a mind game trying to push through that pain. But let me tell you now, it's worth it if you do and you keep that diet up. A couple of weeks, you'll start noticing yourself getting leaner and leaner, your skin getting tighter. It's a fucking really good diet. So pretty much all your meals will be, you can get a bit of carbs, but you got to keep it under 50 grams and make sure it comes all from green vegetables. Personally, I get it from broccoli and spinach, and I just leave it at that. So say a meal will be something like 8 eggs, something like that, and then a small portion of spinach. Another meal will be 200 grams of tuna with a bit of broccoli in it. Another meal will be boiled chicken with a bit of spinach. You can have sardines, you can have grilled fish, cottage cheese, pretty much anything like that. And it is pretty annoying, you get sick of it, but it does work, and I definitely recommend it.
I just took a shit, so let's do a weigh-in. It's currently Monday. I'm gonna be hitting chest and biceps today according to his schedule.
92.2 kgs.
I am 2 meters tall, or 6'7" in Americans. I don't know how many pounds 92.2 is.
This is my current physique. 6'7", 92 kg.
Let's go over my supplements, which is ecdysterone. I'm taking 1400 milligrams of this a day, aka 4 scoops. And I'll be adding Ajuga turgesterone onto this, 2%. Derek More Place More Dates sells 10%. So I'm gonna be taking 5 times as much, which is about 5 grams, so 2.5 grams now, 700 milligrams of this, ecdysterone. And I'm gonna be pinning, which is my B12 medication. You know, obviously Z's was natural, but sadly I have to pin my B12. So let's go ahead and do that and start the day off right and then make some breakfast. I've already been on keto for 3 days so far, so I'm pretty sure my body has already reached a state of ketosis, which means that it's using your fat storages for energy sources. So let's go ahead and put this needle in my leg. Don't worry, YouTube, I'm a prescribed medical patient for this shit, so. All right, that was my B12. Now it's time for some tren. This is what my breakfast will be. My current diet is a little bit of a cut, kind of a maintenance, 2,634 calories, 50 carbs, 100 fat, and 265 protein. 50 carbs is good, but that's gonna maintain ketosis. 8 eggs for breakfast, 100 grams spinach, and 50 grams cashews. So this is the turkesterone and ecdysterone. It's fucking disgusting, but I'ma just slam it down like a shot.
Yo, in this lighting, I'm kinda looking big.
All right, here we go. I just realized I don't have 8 eggs, so I'm gonna be using some egg whites instead. It doesn't really matter. Later today, I'm gonna be doing some grocery shopping anyway. 4 eggs, 200 egg whites, 50 grams of cashews, and 100 grams of spinach.
Too much of this.
Z's claimed that he took Mesomorph and Jack 3D, which are both DMAA containing pre-workouts. DMA is basically Adderall. I'm not taking that myself, but if y'all run up the likes, I might say fuck it and do it for a video. Not sponsored, but my pre-workout of choice is Gorilla Mode.
Whoa.
Let's go ahead and take a look at the training regimen of Z's. He's done a full interview on simplyshredded.com. I'll link the interview in the description down below. And he also shared his workout routine, which I'll be following for this whole week. So today is chest and biceps, but all the other days I'll be following along as well. Start off with the warm-up, little rotator cuff warm-up, and right when the beat drops, boom, look at it, boom. Incline dumbbell presses, 4 sets of 8 to 10 reps. Up next, we have 3 sets of bench press, 8 to 10 reps as well. In this video, Z's did incline bench press, but on the Simply Shredded interview he did, he said flat bench, so I went for flat bench. The next exercise is dumbbell incline flies. This is a friend of mine, Adrian. He helped me film and you'll probably see him in more videos. This is also 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. The next exercise is 3 sets of dips until failure. After that, we're moving on to the arms. We're doing bicep curls, also 3 sets, 8 to 10 reps. And bro, come on, bro. Look at this lighting. Look at it, bro. I look fucking big as shit, bro. Last but not least, 3 sets, 8 to 10 reps of preacher curls. But we're doing a drop set with half the weight, and then you do another 8 to 10 reps. After you get your fat fucking pump in, there's only one thing left to do. Alright guys, I got my broccoli and I bought some eggs after training because I don't have eggs anymore and I didn't have broccoli. Yeah, I decided to just show you guys. I'm gonna be cooking those up later. Just got home from the gym and the store. The pump is pretty whack, I'm not gonna lie. It's kind of mediocre. That's because I have no carbs in my system. Obviously on keto, you're not gonna have glycogen in your muscles. Next to the fact I didn't take Cialis, sometimes I take that for better blood flow. But yeah, right now I'm just super flat and that's something I have to deal with, but I'm definitely shredded. I can see more striations. I'm very happy with the progress that I'm seeing so far. What do you guys think? I'm just keeping the workouts very simple. Just gonna be doing a voiceover over them. Don't wanna do any crazy editing because I just wanna show you guys what Z's workout was all about. I'm not going to eat my lunch right away. Kind of catabolic because I should have a little meal after my workout, but I'm gonna be using these caffeine stims just so I can suppress my appetite a little bit longer and eat a little later. Let me show you guys this. I have a poster in my apartment of Z's. Everybody writes their name on there when they train in my apartment, so that's pretty sick. If you guys come over here, hit a little workout in my home gym, you already know you can put your name on there. I'm about to have my lunch meal, which is 200 grams of tuna, 200 grams of broccoli, 75 grams of cashews. Now, I don't have broccoli. I mean, I do have broccoli. I'm just gonna be using my cauliflower rice because today it would expire. And here's the tuna, by the way. I'm just not gonna be throwing away my cauliflower rice. And honestly, it's fucking beautiful because it still reminds me of having carbs, which I really crave, especially after a workout. Keto is fine. My energy levels throughout the workout are very stable, like very consistent. I don't really notice my strength going down. If anything, it's probably going up because my endurance is going up. I have no carb crash, but after a workout, I am kind of craving carbs because my muscles are so depleted. But then again, my body is working with ketones, which it is now using my fat storages for. So I'm about to be diced in a week, hopefully. I'm gonna finish this meal.
When we get back, we gotta do some crazy, right?
When I get back, I'm gonna eat some tuna. You gotta sleep.
I'm expecting that.
That's how I roll.
Thought you're gonna party or something.
No party. Tuna.
It's like a tuna party.
A tuna party.
I like tuna parties.
A protein party. You wanna come?
Yeah.
You're not invited, man. You're not shredded enough.
And there you have it, the lunch meal for today. 200 grams cauliflower rice, 200 grams tuna, 75 grams cashews. Come on, bro, this tuna is looking beautiful.
Hopefully I'm shredded enough for Z's to invite me to his tuna party. Guess we'll never know.
Dinner time, chicken, red meat, 200 grams, spinach, 200 grams, but I'm gonna be using my cauliflower rice and then cheese, 50 grams, and avocado.
I don't have
cheese.
All right, this is not my proudest meal ever, but I got 200 grams of chicken, one avocado, then the cauliflower rice mixed with the cheese in there. So it's gonna be a little bit like, a little fudgy, a little bit, blah, 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 you know, a little bit creamy. So yeah, I don't know. It's probably gonna be good though. And I like to put some chicken seasoning over all of my food along with some garlic powder. So I'm gonna do that right now and enjoy this meal.
Bro, I don't know what the fuck I created, but this shit is actually butt.
With a little avocado, boom. Little chicken, boom.
Bro!
Face is looking pretty lean. This is the end of the day. I just had some sleepy leaf, and I'm gonna be finishing my two pieces of cottage cheese, 400 grams. Zia said that he ate this before bed because it burns calories while you're sleeping. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. I'm not actually really hungry. I'm deciding to hit my calories anyway because I just wanna maintain the same amount of calories every single day that I'm doing this. I'm still gonna be taking my turkesterone and egg disterone before I go to bed, of course. Peace. Little transition.
30.
Day two. Before I'm going to be eating my breakfast, obviously I'm gonna be taking my supplements, my you know, natty roids over here. I got the turkesterone, I got the egg disterone. Before I'm gonna be eating my fucking breakfast, I am going to
pick up a tripod. I need to get a new tripod so I can film myself in the gym a little better.
Here we go, this is my natty roid shake for the day. Absolutely disgusting.
Here we've got my breakfast. It's 50 grams of cashews, salted cashews, nice for the pump, and cashews got a little bit of carbs in them. Then I'm gonna have 100 grams of spinach with 8 eggs.
Pre-workout, 1 scoop of energy and 1 scoop of pump, nitric. Fun fact, actually, Z stated in an interview that he used DMAA pre-workout. Now, I don't have that at home. Neither am I really interested in it because I love stimulants and I'm pretty prone to addiction, so I'm not gonna be delving into DMAA. I take Adderall once in a while. I have tried DMAE before. Not entirely sure about that compound. It really got me fucked up because I took that like at 7 in the morning after pulling an all-nighter, and I was up the whole day and I recorded 3 videos for my main channel. That shit, that's like meth, bro. It's literally meth. So he used DMAA pre-workout. I'm 100% sure it'll make your workouts fucking insane, but I'm gonna skip on that right now. I'm very content with my Gorilla Mind products, Gorilla Mode. Not sponsored, maybe in the future. Really love that product. And on this channel, I don't have any intent to make money from the things that I use or whatever, because I have my other channel for that. This is just my opinion on stuff.
One-on-one with everyone here. This is Kevin Bros.
You can drink whatever you want. But this shit is the real pre-workout.
Everybody asks me what the fuck is this about? What the fuck is up with those videos, cunt? You're fucking up yourself, cunt. It's a fucking act. There is no cease.
Alright, boys. Today is leg day. You know what that means. I don't know what that means, but you probably do. Before I went to the gym, I put a little half scoop of Gorilla Mode in my shaker so I have some intra workout. Starting off the leg day with 4 sets of squats, 8 to 10 reps. I warmed up with the bar first. Obviously, a good warm up is very crucial, and my knees are pretty weak, so I have to take that into consideration. I worked my way up from 60 kg to 80 kg to 100 kg. I don't go too heavy because my form's shit. Also, something I've been doing is putting these plates under my heels so that way I kind of target the front of my leg more, which is obviously way more aesthetic. Because my form is bad, I don't go heavy and I focus on my depth. I'm trying to hit parallel here. I think I did a pretty okay job. I mean, I'm getting there, so that's all that matters. Next up is 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps lunges. Z did them with the barbell, I did them with the dumbbell. After that, 3 sets of leg press, 8 to 10 reps as well. With the leg press, I don't focus on the heavy weight. I focus on feeling the muscle that I want to target. And I advise you to do the same, because everybody always pushing heavy weight on leg press, but their form is complete shit. So don't do that. After that, we're doing 3 sets of leg extensions until failure. I love this exercise because it's good for your teardrop and the front of your legs. I mean, I love training that shit, so let's go. Up next, we have the leg curls. 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps, of course. I usually go very heavy on this, but right now I focus on contraction. I think that's very important too. I always tell myself, like, the art of moving the weight is more important than the amount of how much you're moving, because if you move the weight cleaner, your muscles are gonna look better. That's it. Last but not least are the calves. C stated that calves are self-explanatory. Just use some of the machines to fill your a lot of reps and feel the burn. So that's what I did. All right, here we go. The lunch meal. It is some sort of a broccoli tuna soup. 200 grams of tuna, 200 grams of broccoli, 75 grams of cashews on the side. Obviously, after my workout, cashews do have a little bit of carbs in them, but my total of carbs will be staying under 50 grams a day, which means that I'm maintaining ketosis. After that, I'm gonna go pick up something from the store, and I decided to start getting my steps in daily again because I do wanna shred down. I wanna look lean. I wanna get 10,000 steps in every single day. At least 5 to 10,000 steps is my goal, because that's an easy 400 to 600 calories extra burned, and this will definitely show in my results. So this is a form of cardio I really enjoy. Just walking around, listening to a podcast or some fucking euphoric music. My playlist will be in the description. I hope you guys enjoy that. I'll be playing some songs from that playlist in this video as well. This video is not that, like, there's not many things going on. I'm trying to keep it short because I'm gonna be filming 7 days each day, like 3 minutes or something, probably a little bit longer because there's 2 off days in here as well. It's very simple. The workout and the diet is super simple, and I'll be showing you guys everything. So I'm gonna be enjoying this meal right now. I'll catch you guys later. Can definitely tell the shreds are coming through. I just went outside and I did like a little bit of walking. I think I got like 8,000 steps in today. I like the diet. I'm not feeling hungry. My energy levels are very stable. Keto is good. Just super flat, bro. If you like bumps in the gym, this is not it. But it's definitely working for me. Looking flat, but losing the fat while maintaining the muscle. Then when I get off keto, I'm gonna resupply my glycogen and my muscles are gonna be like filled up again. I'm gonna look fucking huge because right now, I don't know, it's just muscle and fat. So stripping the fat, re-adding the carbs, supplying the glycogen, getting a filthy bump. Chicken is in the pan. That's for my dinner. Dinner consists of same thing as yesterday. Just gonna have 200 grams of chicken, 200 grams of spinach, 50 grams of cheese, 1 avocado. And then I have some cottage cheeses in the fridge that I just bought at the store. Somewhere this week, I'm gonna have some salmon as well. Otherwise, I have to throw it away. Sheesh, you got mirrors everywhere. Well, I mean, that mirror over there is a lot more aesthetic than this one. This lighting is too real, bro. I'd be eating that cottage cheese, first snack of the day. Got one more of these to finish. I eat these at night because that's what Z's did. I said this yesterday too, bro. I'm having deja vu right now, but eat them at night because something in it, like casein, slow releasing protein, helps you burn fat overnight. If you save some proteins for the end of the day, you know, eat some cottage cheese. Easy fat loss during the night, apparently. Gotta study casein because I'm not 100% on that. That was it for today. I'm gonna have one more of those cottage cheese packets. They're 200 grams each, so 400 grams total today. And actually, I'm feeling really good. I'm also thinking, like, I don't know, I feel like I look really good. Like, striations are definitely like coming through. I mean, check that shit, bro. I got that top thing over here. I don't know, bro. It looked kind of sick to me. Abs are coming through, like the top abs are kind of forming.
Yeah, bro, I'm excited to see what I look like after this week, bro. I'm legit running a cycle out here. Today is back day, Wednesday. I woke up at 11:30, super late. Usually I wake up around 9 or 10, so I'm probably going to go work around 2 or 3. Gonna have my coffee in a bit. I just had my turkesterone and egg-desterone. I also take ashwagandha with it, like 1 gram a day. Half gram in the morning, half gram at night. Yesterday's leg workout was great because I can definitely feel it in my legs, and especially like in the quad part, like the front. Also, my hamstrings are pretty sore. So today I'm gonna be deadlifting and training back. So I don't know how that's gonna work for my hamstrings, but we'll see. I'm excited for today's workout. I'm just gonna wake up a little bit, you know? I need some coffee, man. I need some caffeine in my system, man. This diet's not making me take a shit in the morning. So I'm just away myself before shits, but I won't drink anything.
God damn, boy.
91.5 kg, bro. Last time I weighed it was 92.2 on day 1. What the fuck? I mean,
I am definitely seeing more shreds, especially this fucking serratus shit. Oh my god, bro. But look fucking insane.
This is my breakfast. I got a bell pepper and some cashews below it because it was actually 8 eggs and 100 grams of spinach, but I didn't have enough spinach, so I'm adding a bell pepper instead. Should be fine, bro. And honestly, a little variation. Nothing wrong with that.
Fuck, I'm looking soft. I'm looking soft, but I'm looking fucking nice genetics. God damn, this leg big, boy. This leg a big, boy. They got a big leg, boy. Got a big leg on him, boy. Pre-workout time, we're taking one scoop of the energy, taking one scoop of the nitric, and that's the blend. Let's add some water.
God damn.
Oh, as you can see, I teleported to the gym, so I'm warming up my rotators. Obviously, do this shit. You don't want to injure yourself. You injure yourself, you can't be training for a while, so don't do that. This is dumb. It's Wednesday, so we're training back. Starting off with 3 sets of lat pulldowns, 8 to 10 reps. I wear a hoodie during the first few sets because I still want to warm up a little bit more, and I don't want to walk in the gym mogging everybody right away. I can see it in your eyes. All the years are passing us by. The next movement will be deadlifts. As you just saw, Z is pulling a little 3 deadlifts. I don't know how much kilo that is, but I'm gonna be deadlifting. One of my favorite exercises. 4 sets, 8 to 10 reps. I'm gonna shut up because this track fucking bangs. Next up, we have the bent over rows. Also, 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. For this movement, I think it's super important to squeeze, like when you're at the top, kind of like squeeze your shoulder blades together. You really feel the contraction. I'm not sorry for this angle, but it'll probably make your girlfriend jealous of my gluteus maximus. Next up, as you can see, we're doing some dumbbell rows. 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. And if you don't know how to do this, try pulling from your elbow. It's important to not pull from your biceps on this one. The last exercise in the back workout is hyperextensions. And bro, these shits fucking suck.
He be dead.
This is gonna be my post-workout meal. 200 grams of tuna, 200 grams of broccoli, 75 grams of cashews. Same shit as yesterday. I must say that I had a very tiring workout today, but what can I expect? I'm on a deficit, I'm on keto, and I've trained for 4 days in a row now because I did train 1 day before I started recording this video. My body is giving in. Tomorrow we're training triceps and shoulders, so it should be a fun workout. I'm actually looking forward to that one, especially because it is something I don't really train separately. I train triceps on chest day, and I train my biceps on back day, and shoulders sometimes some light accessory work, but nothing really insane. Having a day dedicated to triceps and shoulders should be interesting. A very colorful looking meal. I just passed the fuck out. But bruh, this diet hitting, bruh. This diet is definitely hitting, bruh. You can see it in my face. Got the jawline coming through, but I'm tired, bro. I had a very tiring workout, but goddamn, bro, I'm about to be shredded as fuck. Shit's coming through. Very happy. So this meal that I have is 2 bell peppers, 50 grams of cheese, there's 100 grams of avocado under there, and 200 grams of salmon. I still had the salmon, I didn't want to throw it away, so that's why I'm having it. Usually it's fish or red meat, Z said, so yeah, I don't mind eating salmon though. A little bit of extra fat, diet's going well, low energy though, but I'm about to enjoy this meal. Getting my daily steps in, 10K a day. Not only am I doing this so I'm like doing more cardio, so I expand more calories than what I eat, but also because I feel like I need to be outside more. I'm inside a lot for my job,
obviously doing media and shit, like my computer a lot, gaming, building websites. Most of you guys probably don't even know what I do, but you'll figure out when you follow me along. Also, on these walks, I listen to great music and I can build my playlist, which will be in the description. I like doing that a lot. And I am probably out of focus this whole time, but doesn't matter, bro. It's beautiful out here. I live in a pretty nice town. It looks very nice, but it's a little bit boring. I need a fucking shave. I'm probably on my off days for this week of training. There's two off days. Probably gonna get a tan and a haircut on these off days. So obviously, bro, that's gonna contribute to aesthetics, and my hair has been pretty fucking ugly, not gonna lie. Here we go, 7.6k steps, not the 10k, but that's sure as hell a lot better than zero steps. Is about like 300, maybe 400 calories or something. About to end the day, take my turkesterone, ecdysterone, and my ashwagandha. Maybe some, I don't need omega-3s right now because I had fish today. Still have my two little packets of cottage cheese that I'll be finishing before bed. And I'm gonna drink some water. I feel a little dehydrated. Today was just a rough day because I slept in, started late, had my meals in late. Then when I got back from the gym, I had a coffee and my meal. And then right after that, bro, I crashed for an hour, completely gone in my bed. Woke up and my right arm was like numb. Like these three fingers were numb. Super weird. Maybe I laid on my arm weirdly or something, but it kind of sketches me out because I have a B12 deficiency. I'll be pinning for that tomorrow again. Good morning, guys. I woke up at 12 or 11:30, bro. Fucked up. Here I got my little, oh my God, this looks disgusting. It tastes fucking disgusting too. Why am I taking this, bro? This is probably not good for you. That was my turkesterone and ecdysterone. Should probably put them in capsules because this shit is fucking ranch. I just did some grocery shopping because I'm almost out of eggs. I mean, I still have four, but I needed some more because 8 eggs in the breakfast and some broccoli rice, spinach, cottage cheese, tuna, and avocado. For my dinner, I'm deciding to cut out the cheese and actually up my proteins because it's more filling. And honestly, I don't like the oily feel on my face, so I'm gonna cut a little bit on fats and see how that goes. So I'll probably be like towards 300 grams of protein a day. Also, if you eat more protein, I learned this from Will Tennyson, then your body uses more energy to actually digest the protein than any other macro. So if you eat more proteins, you'll eventually lean out, even if you're at maintenance. There you go, breakfast, 8 eggs, 200 grams spinach, 50 grams cashews, the same shit as yesterday. Nice. It's 2 p.m. I just scooped up my pre-workout. It's a scoop of Mode and a scoop of Nitric, so this should be good. Not too much caffeine. Gonna go for shoulder and tricep workout today. Let's fucking go. This is probably not a good idea, but I'm gonna have another scoop of Stim just because, or energy. Just because I wanna be geeked out. I'ma just be sipping on that while I'm working out, like kind of intra workout, but it gives me the extra boost during the workout, so that's great. My last spread fucking sucks.
All right, so I teleported to the gym once again, warming up my shoulders and doing some overhead pressing with just a bar to warm up my shoulders. No injuries. Today we're training shoulders and triceps. Starting off with the shoulder press, 4 sets of 8 to 10 reps. Vary this weekly with dumbbells and barbells. Next up, we're doing 3 sets of upright rows supersetted with lateral raises, 8 to 10 reps. Up next, we're doing 3 sets of front raises, 8 to 10 reps. The The last shoulder exercise for today would be the lying rear delt raises, 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. Moving on to the tricep part of the workout, we're starting off with close grip bench, 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps. Obviously, close grip bench is good for your triceps and a little bit of your chest. I warmed up with the bar and then I put on some weights. The second last exercise for today will be 4 sets of tricep pulldowns, 8 to 10 reps. The last exercise for your triceps is 3 sets of skull crushers, 8 to 10 reps.
So I just got home from the workout and took a shower, and I just want to share something. That posing that I did in the gym, it's most of the time looked at weird because people care so much. And especially in the Netherlands, people are extremely judgmental. You should not give a fuck doing that, because I'm doing this for me. I don't give a fuck about what other people think about me. As long as I am not hurting anybody while I'm doing something that I love, it doesn't matter. Because yesterday I realized this, right? The world is your playground, and if you're not treating it as your playground, you're the one being played. So think about that, bro. You either have fun and don't harm anybody in the process. Don't like go out of your way to actually like harm people and shit, but like offending people is no problem as long as it's like based. I guess, I don't know, I should watch out with what I'm saying. But at the other hand, I don't give a fuck, because I don't give a fuck. What I wanna say is, you're gonna leave this earth one day, right? You either leave it a better place or you leave it a worse place. And I'm gonna just try my best and leave it a better place by just doing what I like, doing me, and inspiring other people. That's my goal. So I don't, just as an example, I don't give a fuck when people look at me weird in the gym for posing, because I think I look sick. That's what it's all about. So just wanted to get that out of my head. These stims definitely got me acting up. And,
What the fuck?
It's not like y'all ain't seen this before, but 75 grams of cashews, 200 grams of tuna, 200 grams of broccoli rice underneath. Super simple. I'm having my meal late though, because I was just like stimmed out and I wasn't hungry. My dinner is going to be obviously a little later. It's currently like 5, so I'm gonna have my dinner at like 9 or 10. Little late, but hopefully I'm able to sleep early tonight. Bro, I'm just showing y'all the same meal over and over again. Having dinner right now, I added a little bit of protein, 2 slices of chicken instead of 1, so about 350-400 grams. I did less cheese and I added an avocado with the broccoli rice over here. Wait, hold up. Looks like a lot nicer meal. Boom, home gym in the background. Who does it like me, bro? Who the fuck got a home gym in his kitchen, bro? I'm dedicating my life to these gains, baby. I'm gonna enjoy this meal and have these cottage cheeses later tonight. Yup, you already know what time it is. It is hydrocobamine time, bro. That means I got a fucking needle over here and I'm about to inject myself with vitamin B12. I have a deficiency, if you didn't know. I already said this in the video, bro. If you don't know, scroll back, bro. Go back in the video. Not fucking feeling it, because from the workout where I hit legs, I've been in my quads, so that's gonna be fun.
I feel like such a fucking druggie doing this shit, bro. It's fucking 1 milliliter too. Actually, no, it's 2 milliliters, bro.
Well, I'm fucking glad that's over, because that one fucking hurt. Bro, I already know what you're about to say. I look beautiful, man. I'm about to have my anabolic natty roids cup of water. So 1 egg disterone. Then 1 heapski of turkesterone. You can't even see that. Another slight heaper.
Man, I spilled turkesterone all over my camera, bruh.
Alright, I'm about to sip this shit and then take this Zorro mask off. This is never gonna be good, bro. It's the end of the day. I had 3 of these cottage cheese packets, bro. I went 180 calories over. I simply did.
Starting to look pretty dangerous. I'm not really dangerous. I don't know how to fight.
Fuck, I'm fucking aesthetic as shit.
Good morning, guys. It's currently, fucking 11. It's my off day today. So I'm gonna get a haircut. I got driver's lessons today. Gonna get my fucking hair chopped off.
Currently, I've had my breakfast already. 200 grams of spinach, 8 eggs. Didn't have the cashews because that's usually a little bit of carbs. But I'm not working out today, so I'm gonna see how it feels if I skip out on the cashews. I got driver's lessons in 20 minutes, so I'm about to go to the pickup spot and fucking kill it. I took one Addy. I just wanna make sure I don't fucking fail, so I'ma go to learn mode real quick. And I'll update you guys when I get my driver's license. You guys will definitely know, bro. Cause if I do get my driver's license, then I will I'll go places with my car and the videos will be a lot more fun to watch. Because we'll be going places together, you and me. Let's go. Just started my driver's lessons. Went pretty well. Off the Addy, didn't really feel it. Still don't really feel it. Not hungry though. The 8X still filled me up. 200 grams spinach. Didn't really need the cashews. Getting a haircut, going to the store. Picking up some protein, probably chicken. I did not get a haircut. Hair salon was occupied, so tomorrow I'm gonna get one. Tomorrow is also the last day of working out that Z's did, which will be a full body workout. I'm kind of excited for it because my body needed a rest today, and then tomorrow should be an exciting day because everything should be bumped up. Deadlifts, squats, clean and jerk, and then weighted pull-ups, I think. I'm having some tuna right now with some spinach. It's gonna be my lunch, even though it is 5:31, so a little late lunch. And then tonight, I'm gonna have a big piece of red meat, some broccoli probably. No fats, skipping out on the fats for today. Maybe I'll have some cashews as a snack.
Ladies, gentlemen, I'm having my dinner on time. It's currently, I don't know the time.
An avocado with a bavette. Look at this beautiful piece of meat. And then one broccoli.
Then that should be enough for today, but I'm still having my cottage cheese at night. I skipped out on the cheese and on about 75 grams of cashews, which is a lot of fat cut, and hopefully it'll make me feel better. There's still a lot of good fats, like in the avocado and in the meat. And the meat is a little bit of fat. And in the eggs, of course, in the morning. This is also, this is probably the leanest I've ever looked, by the way. I can't wait to actually carb up and then refill my glycogen and look fucking huge, because right now all the glycogen on a keto diet is out of your muscles.
Gotta resupply that because I'm looking flat. I'm just looking flat, but low-key kind of peeled. After my dinner, I had two of these. Dinner was pretty good. Currently cooking up some chicken in here in the new pan. I got a new pan, bro. Really appreciate the new pan. It's an amazing pan. Look at this pan. It's a crazy pan. So making that chicken, maybe having a little piece right now, maybe tomorrow. A little hungry and I need a shave because I do not really like facial hair on myself. I look older. I prefer a clean shave because then my jawline is way more defined. I'm feeling bloated. I had two cottage cheese, so that's sitting right here.
Del Cielo, I believe, something like that. My goal for this trip is...
All right, I'm having my chicken over here, one chicken breast, about 200 grams. It's looking actually pretty fucking good, and I'm excited for it. I'm watching some James English, and then when I finish this, I'm gonna just go to bed, and see you guys tomorrow. I look like this, bruh. Damn. Sheesh. Just got this Young LA order in, the little stringers, and the hat. Goddamn, look like a fucking TikToker right now. Sleep schedule is not fixed. I'm about to have my breakfast, make 8 eggs. And then today is the last day of training like Z's. Then tomorrow, I will still be eating like him. Later today, I'm gonna get a haircut. Yo, God, this hat really is floating on top of my head, bro. That's how TikTokers do it. I like how this stringer actually fits me. I'll one day be a sponsored athlete by some sort of company that I like. But for now, it's just stuff that I genuinely fuck with. And honestly, if I ever get sponsored by anything, I will not get sponsored by something if I don't fucking like it, because I don't have this channel to make money. I've said this in other videos. It's like, I have my other channel where I do gaming videos and I can make money on there, but I don't have to do anything out of pocket on this channel to make money. Yeah, sure, if I get sponsored by something I genuinely like Gorilla Mind or Young LA, like the clothing I just bought with my own money, then yeah, I'll take the sponsorship because I fucking love those products. I'm gonna have my breakfast and then lift. Fucking, let's go! Full body.
Sheesh. Don't have spinach. I'm gonna go get that from the store after I'm done working out. This is gonna be fine anyway. 8 eggs. I'm gonna have the spinach later.
It doesn't really affect my working out anyway. I will have cashews with this, which I just forgot, so I'm gonna grab 50 grams of cashews and enjoy my meal, get some pre-workout in, and then hit the fucking weights. My physique after eating and training like Z's for a week. I don't know if there's much of a difference. Probably looking a lot flatter and probably more striations showing because of the keto, you know, drying me out. It was pretty fun to try, and I'm gonna still do keto and slowly introduce carbs back into my diet.
You don't even have to say it, bro. God damn, this fresh air kind of looking good. Maybe it's a little bit short. Maybe around the ears a little too short, but fuck it, I'm fucking with it. Look like fucking Chad. Man, who the fuck am I kidding? This video is literally gonna get like 500 views, bro.
Whipping up an experimental meal. I got 200 grams of tuna here. I didn't buy the spinach that I was going to buy because, god damn, yo, what the fuck? Who the fuck is Hans Smith? Okay, so basically, I'm using some egg whites with the tuna, and then I'm also gonna be adding a little bit of hummus. So not too much, because hummus is actually kind of high in carbs. Per 100 grams, there's 12 grams of carbs, so I wanna keep that low. Gonna be using 50 grams of hummus or something, so it's like 5 grams of carbs, which is what I usually get from the spinach. So this is the meal, 200 grams tuna, about 50 or 70 grams of hummus, and then I sprinkled some cashews over there just for the taste, and honestly, looks like a pretty good meal to me. Could use a little bit of green, but lucky, I already got that green in me. So this will be my dinner. I got one steak over here, 300 grams, and then two eggs with a cottage cheese and some soy sauce in it. I'm gonna mix it around, and it's gonna make the cottage cheese taste a little bit better, a little more salt. It's a very simple meal, but I don't have any vegetables, so I gotta pick those up tomorrow again. Just took a shower. It's currently like 1 a.m., but I'm about to do a little night walk. I wanna get some extra steps in, and then tomorrow morning, do fasted cardio. And then after that, I wanna see what my physique looks like. Obviously, a more dried out, more lean look, because I haven't been eating now. I'll be getting my steps in a bit, and then tomorrow morning, some cardio. So that'll be the last day. I'll be getting a tan somewhere later this week, but probably not tomorrow. So that won't be in this video. Gonna be going for a walk now, and see you guys tomorrow when I'm probably doing the cardio.
Guys, I have a coffee bean at. I got these pills. I got Rovalstein, Alfio Himbine, and I got Fat Burner.
And I'm gonna be going to the gym. So I have a black coffee, I have these pills, and then I'm gonna go to the gym, do some cardio work. And then, you know, that's gonna be wrapping up the video, actually, because that's the last thing I'm gonna do in this video. I woke up 91.8 kg, so not really that light. Yesterday, I did eat something when I got back from the walk, so that kind of sucks, but I kept it limited to like 500 calories or something. I'm excited to, I'm not fucking excited for this cardio, but I'm excited to see what I look like after I do this cardio, because
Gotta get rid of this water.
I got calf veins, bro. There's a big ass vein over here. All right, so it definitely made leg gains. That's crazy. I love that. I love seeing that. Especially here, the teardrop. I've been working on that quite a lot recently with the leg extensions. And it's showing. Slowly morphing into a real life fucking giant anime character, bro.
Just got done with my cardio, did 30 minutes on the incline, regular walking. That's it for this video actually, because I don't really have anything else to say. What I can say about this diet is it definitely leaned me out, but that's because on keto, your glycogen storages are just going empty. So I'm looking flat, but I'm looking leaner. I can definitely tell. I'm gonna stay keto for a little bit. I'm enjoying the constant energy levels, and the workout program Z's used was actually really nice, and I learned a lot of things from it. Like, on my chest day, I'll start off doing incline dumbbells now because that's good for the upper chest, which is something I want to grow. Look, like, it's a little dip here for my clavicles, so I want to be training that a little bit more. Anyway, guys, if you enjoyed, let me know in the comments down below. Subscribe. I don't care if you don't or if you do, but I do read all the comments. And if you made it this far into the video, let me know some comments down below of video ideas of who I should train and eat like or something, because I feel like that is a pretty fun concept to do. But that said, bro, it's a long ass video and took me a lot of time to make this. So see you guys in the next video.
Peace.
What the fuck, bro? What the fuck is with this fucking Ziz cunt, bro? You think you're a fucking mad cunt, bro? Yeah, fucking exchange, bro. I'll fucking lay out Ziz. Look at you, fucking little wonk faggot with your fucking hair, your fucking fairy cunt. Yeah, I'll fucking lay out, bro. I'm gonna fucking dry fit. Look at it, it's fucking picked up, cunt. You know what that means, cunt? That means I'm a fucking sick cunt. I'll fucking lay out, cunt.